Hey everybody, before today's video begins, I want to give a big shout out to NVIDIA for sending out this awesome care package, which features an RTX 2080 Ti, a pair of the night vision goggles that come in the limited edition, dark edition of Modern Warfare, and this gigantic care package. In this video though, we are going to be reviewing the night vision goggles, because I know that a lot of people have been wondering about that, and I asked over on Twitter a few weeks back if I should do a review of them. I just happened to get them early because of the awesome folks at NVIDIA. So we're gonna go ahead and take a look at them today in this video. I hope you all enjoy. So here is the night vision goggles. And these come in the limited edition, the dark edition of Modern Warfare. These are fully functional and they actually work. I think here though, I think this lens and this lens are just for show, because once you look on the inside, you could see through, and I'll take it off the stand so we can take a look at it. You can actually see in both of these lenses, but I think it's only these, this first one here, and it's like transmitting to the other side, because inside it's kind of like a screen. You'll see what I mean when I actually put the camera down and try to present something of worth, because it's hard to look through night vision goggles with a camera. I'm gonna be honest with you. On the front here, you can see that there's like some knobs and things, but they don't really do much. These ones do. These knobs right here actually position this entire module. This moves left and right, so you can turn that here. This doesn't do anything. I think that's just for show. There's two buttons on the top right here, and these buttons actually adjust for the size of your face. That way it's in the correct area and it's not actually going to harm you in any way. It's not going to be bumping up against your head like I believe the Modern Warfare 2 night vision goggles did that. And then on the front right here, we have a little button. You push this in and you're able to actually move the night vision goggles up into a upward position to get them out of your way. And then you can push that in to flip them down, and they lock in place too. So it's pretty nice. Then on the back, you have a battery pack, which you don't have to touch this at all. And the cool thing is, this is a completely rechargeable system. So you're not gonna constantly be swapping batteries out. You're just going to have to recharge them. So here's the battery pack. And it's definitely just for show, because the battery that's inside is rechargeable. It comes with a micro USB and you just charge right there. So the cool thing is, this is marked with the XRK. When I originally saw XRK at the Modern Warfare reveal, I didn't understand what it was. I thought maybe it was just them kind of making up their own brand. And that's definitely what it was, because now we know that the XRK weapons pack exists. So it's kind of cool to see the tie in there. On the bottom, you're going to see that there's little switches here. And the switches actually control the lenses, so you can focus them depending on where they're resting on your face, which I think is really nice. There's lots of different adjustments you can make. On the bottom here, you're also going to see the controls. So right here you have power on, you have the mode, which will switch between a black and white night vision and a green night vision, and then you have a long range mode. This long range will turn on a couple of IR lights here on the front, and those IR lights will go out quite far actually, and they're going to work really well. But just from here, I'll go ahead and show you. I'll flip up this part here so we can actually get a better view altogether. We're gonna go ahead and just move on over to an actual camera phone, because it's a little bit easier to stick a lens in there. I can't really do it with my DSLR, I apologize. But you can see that it's currently on and operational. So since I don't have anywhere dark to test right now, it's the middle of the day and I want to get this video out, I'm going to go up into the attic and then my brother's going to lock me in there and turn off the light, which is located downstairs. And this is going to be kind of sketchy, but it should be dark enough up there to test this. And since it stretches the length of the house, we should be able to see pretty good up there. So let's do it. This is what I'm seeing in the attic. That orange light at the end, that is an electrical wire. And it just shows that there's power going to it. This is really sketchy. But we're gonna go ahead and get this going.
I have to record with my phone because we're not going to be able to see it properly with this DSLR. So I apologize. Let's go ahead and take a look through my phone.
I just want to reiterate to everyone that's watching this video, it is extremely difficult to record this, but what you're looking at right now is the sight picture that you get when wearing it. It looks like a square, but when both of your eyes are on both of the lenses, you will still see this square, this portrait image. So there's a couple different modes that you can select from. This first mode is what is just automatically given, and this is like a green night vision like you would normally see in the Modern Warfare series. Then you can switch it to this black and white night vision. However, I've noticed the green gives more definition, and you can actually see a little bit farther with it. But you can switch this on the fly to whatever you want. Now what we're going to do is turn on the extended IR lasers, or the extended IR lights, which give a spotlight effect to the area you're looking. And it actually works. I mean, it works a little bit better in this mode, I think. Obviously, you can see a difference here. Nothing's lit up down there. And then when I turn the light on, you can actually see everything that's wrong with my house and all the asbestos up here, I'm sure. After you click it off, you can just turn it off or, you know, continue using them. So this is what it looks like. It's not bad, and it actually works at a distance. I would say that that light down there is shining probably like 50 feet. That's pretty far back. But yeah, it's got definition, and when you're looking at it with your own eyes, it looks much better than when I'm putting a camera up against it. So that is what these look like.
So there's one other cool thing that I want to show you in regard to the night vision and how it gets set. So during the day, the night vision's not automatically on. Instead, you'll see a normal picture with the normal colors you see around you. And then if you head into a dark area, there's a sensor on the front of the goggles that will actually turn them on automatically for you. So if you listen closely, you might be able to hear it. That's really cool. I really, really like that. So I just want to do a couple final thoughts on these. They're definitely way better than the Modern Warfare 2 night vision goggles from all those years ago. Obviously, technology has advanced quite a bit, so making something like this it's going to be a little bit better quality. When the IR lights are on, these will glow red. Same with these. I'll get a picture and put them on the screen right now so you can take a look. But overall, I really like the offering. I mean, obviously there's some plastic bits to keep the price down, but it doesn't feel like a toy that you would spend $20 on. It feels like something of quality, and it works quite well from what you've seen. Lots of different adjustments that you can make, an auto sensor, which is right above this IR light, if you can see it reflecting right there. But overall, really like them. I think it's good quality. If you ended up getting or pre-ordering the dark edition of the game, I think you're going to be more than satisfied with these night vision goggles. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video and first look at the Modern Warfare night vision goggles. If you did, do me a favor, drop a like on the video to help support it. And of course, if you have not yet, don't forget to click that subscribe button, join the notification squad by ringing the bell icon, and hopefully I'll catch you all on the next video. Peace.